Hi, this is Jim Lipuma of the New Jersey Institute of Technology, and I'm recording this for my technical communications class. It is material drawn from my book, Fundamentals of Undergraduate Education and Learning. Our topic today is communication, and it comes in four parts. Part one of four is the transmission model. When you think of communication, it's helpful to go back a little bit and think about where this model first began. The transmission model really looks at communication as simply the transmission of something from one thing or person to another. And in the 1950s, the researchers at Bell Labs were interested in improving the quality of phone communications, and that's the model they used. They thought of someone picking up a telephone, dialing a message, and having a conversation with another person. And so the aspects of the transmission model come from that basic system. Now, that's one perspective. And in this case, it's considered a third-party observer in which you're looking at all the parts and you're not participating. But there are other perspectives which you can use. Later on in this course and in the future parts of this communication definition, we'll begin to look at that if you're part of the system, your perspective and the way you define the aspects of it may change. For many college students, they're used to being the receiver of information, the place where things are directed. What we want to do is eventually change it so that you, as a student, are the sender and the one who's making all the choices about what and how the process occurs. So let's actually look at the aspects of the model with its parts. The first part is to think of the sender. This is the person or thing which is transmitting. And this term can be source, can be sender, can be transmitter, any word, but for us we want to think of it as sender. Then on the other side is the aim of your transmission, which is your receiver. This can also be recipient, sink, target, audience, many different words, but it's where the transmission is directed. And so the idea is that it's the process of getting it from one to the other. Now, the thing that is being transmitted is usually termed the message. For many people, they conceive of this as data, information, knowledge, feelings, emotions, ideas. All of this, in its simplest sense, will be termed message. Now, next is the medium, or the way in which the transmission occurs, the method of delivery. As we go through this course, you'll learn much more about different kinds of mediums and how mediums and message are connected. But for now, just think about the way in which it's delivered is the medium. Now, lastly, the researchers came up with the idea of noise or static. And this is anything which interferes with the successful transmission of the message. When you're talking about a phone call, this can be static on the line or the inability to connect. This is the basic transmission model. If you move on to part two, we'll talk about how this is developed more in the modern view of communication. Thank you.